Now, they've travelled to 50 locations around the globe and have spent more than 250 hours underwater, all in search of the world's best dive locations.
Carrie Miller and her husband Chris Taylor were newlyweds when they set off on a 14-month adventure that would lead to their new book, A Diver's Guide to the World, for National Geographic. And they join us now. What a wonderful life. Welcome, guys. So it was one giant honeymoon, really.
Yeah, it was just a big adventure, but it was so much fun.
Oh, fantastic. Why don't you tell us your story, guys? We believe that you met on the job. Is that right?
Yeah, we did. So I was working for Rodney Fox Shark Expeditions in South Australia, and Carrie was writing a story for National Geographic about diving with great white sharks. So I introduced her to her first white shark.
Oh, sounds like you're a bit of a shark yourself, yeah.
Right. What was that on the water?
This is awesome. Yeah, so tell us about this book. Who's this book for?
So this book is a dive travel guidebook, so it includes both land and underwater adventures. And while it's primarily written for scuba divers, and we think divers are absolutely going to love it, there's also a lot of information in there for travelers who are interested in the ocean, as well as new divers who are inexperienced or who are just thinking about giving diving a try.
I would love to do that. I just found out that Jess was a diver. What's your car? You were a diver instructor?
I used to live in lived in the Maldives for 12 months, and I was a snorkel guide, but I made up my qualification. So every time the rich people would ask me what fish was that, it was a black and white one, so it was zebra fish. And then if they questioned me, I just told them it was breeding season, and they'd get pretty aggressive, let's move on. So I really loved it there.
She can do it. Have you guys dived in the Maldives before? Have you met Jess before over there? What are some of the most extraordinary places? That's what I'm getting at. The most extraordinary places that you've been to, because this is great.
So, yeah, there, pretty much everywhere in the book was absolutely extraordinary. It was an incredible adventure. But probably one of the standout destinations was where we ended our trip, and that was in Cocos Keeling Islands, right here in Australia.
Wow.
So it's absolutely stunning. And as you can see, it looks a bit like the Maldives as well. Mm. So I think a lot of people are very surprised when they hear about it, and I guess a lot of people don't know about it. But it's a wonderful place to take your family, and it's very family friendly, and yeah, some incredible diving out there.
Oh my gosh, it's beautiful! I didn't know that was there.
Just the country we live in, yeah.
I love that this is it's an underwater love story. Was the first time you saw each other? Was it through the goggles, like the magnified look of each other's eyes just drew you in? And then was it the mouthpiece that, you know, like, pfft, like what was, when did you first lay eyes on each other?
Well, it was when Chris was putting on my weight belt to chuck me in the cage with great white sharks. So he just kind of wrapped me up in my weight belt and said, there you go, and off I went.
Oh, wow.
And the rest is history. There's nothing like a woman in a weight belt to get you going, is there, John?
No, she
couldn't run anywhere fast.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it. So tell us about yourselves then again. I mean, what have you learned about each other getting to travel around here together? I think it's so great, doing stuff that you love. You obviously have an interest in the water, potentially climate change, I imagine, as well, isn't it?
Yeah, unfortunately, everywhere we went, we saw climate change. It's happening now. When we were traveling to places, the people we met on the ground said that in the last 5 years especially, weather patterns are changing, species are migrating. But also everywhere we went, we met legions of people and organizations on the ground who are fighting to make a difference. And that gave us a lot of hope and inspiration. And we included that in the book so that if people are interested in learning more about what they can do to make a difference, there is that information.
Now, Chris, we do hear that you would have preferred to write a book specifically about the best shark dives in the world. I understand this would be some very debated debates over your lunch, maybe. Is this true?
It is absolutely true. I absolutely love sharks. And yes, if it had been up to me, I would have written just a book about 50 shark dives. But I am also aware that there's a lot of people out there that would prefer to do something else while diving. So we had to keep that in mind. But that being said, for me, diving with sharks is the absolute highlight for any dive. They're really important for the ecosystems, so it's great to see them in the water, and they're just spectacular animals. And hey, if either of you are keen, I'd love to take you out and introduce you to some sharks.
Yeah.
I'm not going to turn that one down.
Tristan never says no to a freebie.
A zebra shark, is it?
A zebra shark. Yeah, that's a grey shark. That's a grandma. That's a grandma shark. It's a grey shark. Time to move on.
You know what? Speaking of fantastic animals, you two are they. You're awesome. Yeah. If you'd like to get your hands on A Diver's Guide to the World, head to any good bookstore in person or online. Thanks so much for your time, Carrie and Chris. And thanks for that offer. 100% I'll take you up on that one.
Thank you very much for having us.
Thank you.
Good on you. Keep educating, keep happy.